Here's a quick little tutorial on how I do shoulder pads. So if you start with one stick, you're going to be throwing it to the opposite shoulder, and it's going to do this rocking motion. And we're going to catch it with our thumb turned in like this and bring it down. Right? Down. 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 Okay? Toss, catch, down. Toss, catch, down. And we're leaning to the opposite side of that shoulder. So my left shoulder, I'm leaning to the right. Boom. 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 You can do this kind of more horizontal, or you can do it more vertical. Looking at it from the side, you kind of want your the end of your staff to come up right around about 11 o'clock there. Just a little bit above halfway. Okay. And my release point is right here. Like right in front of my sternum. My hand comes up, releases right there, down, up, down. And so you're really trying to get that hesitation. Nice long rocking motion there. If you throw too hard, you're gonna go over the back. Too soft, it's gonna end up like that and you can't get your hand quite under it. So again, right about there. Okay, now two sticks. same thing, start with your dominant hand. We're gonna go right, left, and then catch, catch. Right, left, catch, catch. Right, left, catch, catch. Okay? So if they're clanking in the back, probably too horizontal, or maybe throwing the second one a little too soon, and you try to pull this one and it hits that one. So just work on your timing and work on your height of your tails there. Whoosh, 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 like that. See how they just come up just a little bit, hesitate. Gives me time to get everything out of the way. Nothing is clanking. Okay, and I'm doing my rocking motion there. Boom, boom. And the exercise here is going to be for you, it's going to be left, right, right, left, left, right, right, left. Okay? And the next thing to do is see how quickly you can do that pattern between grabs. So it's like as soon as you release the second one, grab the first one. See how quickly you can do that? Right, left, left, right, catch, catch, okay? And then you're gonna see how long you can make that gap. So, like that, really draw it out as long as you can. Okay, and we're kind of rocking back and, we're kind of rocking back and forth when we do this, maintaining the same height. Boom, boom. Okay, and my release point's right about here. Okay, now with three, I'm gonna hold my two in my dominant hand, circus grip, and the one I'll be releasing is the one on the bottom, this one. And I'm gonna reach up, release, and go for, again, you want it to be not too low and not too hard to fly over your shoulder. And do like a shoulder roll. Also, real quick, if you have weighted ends, more so than me, that's gonna make it a little bit different. There's gonna be a finer line between the tipping point, if you will, between like just right and then too far, and it flips over. So you'll have to find that balance. Anyways, so with three, it's gonna be left. And again, if they're hitting behind you, you might be throwing them too hard. One's going up way too far back there. And so then it hits right here. And like I said, the timing might be off. It's really slow. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Like that. Trying it a little bit more vertical will help keep you from hitting them. And then maybe you can kind of ease it into a little bit more of a horizontal plane. And notice my release point is in the same spot each time, right there at the center of my chest. And I hold mine on my silicone tape here. So I guess that's a quarter way, ballpark of a quarter way up. Okay. Notice the heights of my tails, all about the same, releasing right in the center of my chest right there like that, and maintaining the rock. And yeah, that's how I do shoulder pads.